From now on, I will use a few shortcuts here and there to jump around the editor and get different things done. I'm doing this on a Mac, thus I'm going to use the Command key a lot. But most shortcuts work just as well on Windows by substituting Command with Control. Searching and finding matters a lot to me. Hitting Command T will bring up the fuzzy file finder. The search box forgives many spelling mistakes or omissions, so jumping from file to file gets lightning fast. Most developers prefer this method over manually searching for a previously opened tab, as this involves zero mouse input and no thinking about the tab position. It's a perfect example of an action that looks more complex than clicking on a tab, but is actually faster and simpler. Typing an @ symbol into that box, or directly typing Command R will bring up the symbol search menu. This allows you to quickly locate stuff in the current file, and it works extremely well for CSS or JavaScript functions. Now, I know I use this color somewhere else in the CSS file, and I want to quickly locate it. So I have it already selected, and on my keyboard, I'm going to hit Command, Alt, and G, and it finds the next instance of it. Sublime Text has a very powerful tab completion feature. In a nutshell, tab completion allows you to type a whole lot less, and typing less usually results in your finishing faster. So if I go into my HTML file and type in img and hit tab, it expands it out to the full image tag. Notice how not only it created an image tab with the most important attributes for us, it also placed the cursor in the right position for us to enter information in. Many editors support multiple selection these days. That's the ability to have multiple selections in the same document that aren't next to each other. But most of the time, folks show that off with column selection, which can be done by holding the Alt key and dragging your cursor around. It sure looks cool, but the use cases for it are so rare that I almost never use it. So let's see how we can do this the Sublime way. So I have this word color right here selected, and I've pressed Command D, and it shows us the next instance of that word without clearing the selection of the first. And it doesn't stop there. Command Control G selects all instances of the word throughout the whole file. You can think of it as a global selection. So this makes it very easy for us to quickly refactor.